Welcome to the first ever Sonoy convention. Now you all know how it's pronounced. Actually, it's Sonoy. That's the one word. Sonoy. That's the one word. The one thing I didn't explain on the website. Yeah. Welcome. Very short speech from me. Then we will have Florian Florop to say something from the venue, from the club, to you, and then we will begin with our first speaker. So, I want to thank at first for all the help we got. For first, I want to thank the Chaos Computer Club Cologne for hosting the event, for giving us the rooms, and also from the Helping Hands. So they are in the back there and cooking, brewing coffee and such things. So thank you. Then I want to thank all the donations that we received so far that enabled us to actually plan and start the event. Very nice. And also, and thank you in advance for any donations we will receive maybe from you during the event, like I wrote in every email, I think. I want to thank the people of the so-called Open Source Audio Meeting Cologne, which is a regular meeting we do here actually every month about the same topics, but it's in German. But we can sometimes I consider this the extension of the monthly meetings. So thank them for helping, for setting up the rooms and so on. Okay. Speaking of sponsors, each talk and demo will be not sponsored by, but we will use this opportunity. Right now, I want to thank Markus Seber for supporting the event. Yeah. Now, audience, thank you for coming here, of course. Last thing about the donations. I'm very pleased that this is a totally independent event. We have no corporate sponsors or anyone telling us what language we should use, no swear words or such things. No, it's absolutely independent, and I think that's a very good thing that we are not dependent on anyone. Okay, and of course, thanks to all the speakers, to all our in the room, to all the speakers who volunteer to present something here. They arrived at their own expenses, and this is without this would not be possible. Thank you. Okay. One smaller sentence about what everywhere on the page, on the website, and in every announcement I said, this is an event about open source, music, technology, and so on. So I want to say a few things about what is this open source in this context. Many people know, some may not know, it doesn't matter. I don't mean a particular ideology with it. For me, I'm on the pragmatic side, on the convenience side. So open source is a set of software or resources like sampling or sampled instruments also. And for me, open source means they can be used without any hesitations, without any limitations in any kind of professional, commercial, non-commercial, hobbyist environment without worrying. You don't need a legal team, basically, once once you know a bit about this. So this is very very reassuring for me. It creates an environment of trust, trusting the software, trusting your own computer. That's why I want to support this. It's not a movement, but people who decide to release resources and software as open source. I want to support this this event. And of course, there are other events in the same regard, but not about music, not in this. There are events for programmers or software developers, but not for musicians. So this is this side. And once you know, have a sharp understanding of what is open source, and here I mean just it's a set of licenses. Basically, license is a text that says what you can do and what you can't do, and open source tends to be on the you can do side. So once you memorize some abbreviations like GPL or MIT or Apache license or various BSD licenses and also the Creative Commons licenses, once you know what this is, you begin to see them labeled by software and by music even, and you you begin to recognize, ah, this is a source I can use. I can in programs you can trust. Okay, and this for me, I said this is a pragmatic decision. What you can do with the software, no restrictions, basically. For me, in the education sector, I'm a teacher. This is very, very convenient. I don't need to go to all the paperwork and all the licenses, and then a pupil comes and asks, can I use this at home? And I have to say, no, you don't. Or yeah, you have to let them sign an agreement, a written agreement, pupils of 10 years old, that, I don't know, strange world. With open source software, it doesn't happen. You can just say, yeah, download it, or here, I give it to you. Another benefit, and the last I want to say, compared to some blanket term or mysterious term like freeware, where I make a distinction. So freeware, of course, you can say it's the same. You get it for free. You can use it mostly without any restrictions. With the restrictions, I'm not so sure. Sometimes you have to read the text, and they say not for commercial or only in the name of some political agenda or whatever. I've seen it all. And one result of open source software is the widespread availability. So exactly for different operating systems, it makes the software independent of operating systems, because even though most of us are not programmers, and this often cited, with open source software you can review the code, you can change it. Of course, that in the real world that is not the case, but at least some people can do it, and the first thing normally they do is to make the software available for your operating system. For me, it's Linux. For other people, it's Windows software that was only available for macOS. So it's very convenient that way. So this is the kind of software and environment we are dealing with here. And I think it's beneficial if this gets a more wider platform and more audience. Now, let's hear some welcoming words from Florian Zeitz, also known as Florop, who will speak for the Chaos Computer Club.
Thank you, Niels. Again, welcome to Sonar Convention. My name is, as you've heard, Florian Zeitz, or more commonly around these parts, Florop. And as you've also heard, I've been asked to welcome you on behalf of the Chaos Computer Club here in Cologne. Some words on the Chaos Computer Club, just so you kind of know what you've gotten yourself into by coming into these rooms, let's say. We are, as you might or might not have read, the largest European hacker community. And what we do is deal with the connections between society and technology, what happens when technology gets into the public life, what happens in those regards. And we're taking part in the public discourse in that a lot. Like most recently, there's been some discussion on data retention laws in the European Union. we've worked with software that's used for demoting systems, and we're trying to create and help with public discourse in those regards. The CCC is very loosely organized. Like, there is a big organization called the Chaos Computer Club, which is like Germany-wide. But generally, most of the actual work happens in something that's called ERFAS, which like loosely translates to something like experience exchange circles. The word is about as old as it sounds. And you've found yourself in the Cologne version of that, which is basically a local hackerspace, and don't necessarily like that word, but hackerspace, with people who are of a common mindset. That mindset within the CCC is usually defined in terms of what we call the hacker ethics, originally defined by Stephen Levi. It's been extended in around the 80s by the CCC for the version that we use by 2 points, which are don't litter in other people's data and make public data available, protect private data. So as most of you hopefully know, we're not the hackers that media would have you believe that hackers usually are. Like, we are the good guys or something like that. What we use as a definition of hacking is usually using technology creatively, using technology in a way that it wasn't necessarily meant to use, but to create something more than it is. Obviously, that does include definitions of abusing systems in a way that cause security exploits, but that's not the mindset that finding those is coming from necessarily. That's getting creative with your technology. More points from those hacker ethics are actually like access to computers and anything which might teach you something about the way the world really works should be unlimited and total, and all information should be free. So as you can guess from that, we are a curious folk and we'd like to understand technology. And naturally, from coming from there, we like the open source movement. We like being able to understand how the software we use day to day works. We like looking at it. And maybe related to this conference, we like understanding how the instrument you're using works and looking at it and being able to tinker with it in the ways you want to. Right. The last point I wanted to make is also from the hacker ethics, one point that says you can create art and beauty on a computer. And I think that's very relevant to the event today, because art and beauty obviously encompasses also audio and music and creating those things. So we're very happy to have Sonoy at this space. We're very happy to monthly host the open source audio meetup here in Cologne, because I think it's a really good fit for the computer club. Yeah. Let me say some words on the amenities we have here. There are two toilets, which you may or may not have seen. No matter what some jokes they may have put on there, they're both unisex and they're both free. the main difference that one has a shower, but you probably won't need that. Hopefully you won't need that. Other than that, there is a large fridge which has drinks. You can pick up some yourselves. There is a cash box on the wall next to the big cupboard. Otherwise, ask people that are running around there. They'll help you. Most things are 150, but there's also a huge price list posted in multiple spaces. And I think that's it from me. So I'll head back to Niels, and be excellent to each other.
So while he's setting up, I forgot one important thing. No, I didn't forget it. I took my time to say it now. A big thanks to the people from the Chaos Computer Club, from the so-called VOC, right? No? Who do the video recording and streaming and do the live mixing, audio mixing here for us. So that's a huge, I think that's a very huge value. And there are actually people watching this right now, waited for the stream and requested it. And yeah, thank you for that.